Hi guys, my name is Jhon, Arief, and welcome to my shop. I have a big problem with the dust. I think all woodworkers have a problem with dust. And I never had a proper dust collector before because it's expensive and I cannot afford. Years ago, I used a vacuum cleaner, but it didn't last long until the motor is failed. So last week, I convinced myself to build a dust collector blower. So this blower, I'm using a 13.5-inch diameter of impeller, and I'm using 1 horsepower motor with 2,800 RPM, and it turns out it's great. It's beyond my expectation, and it's have a very good static pressure. This video is going to be a little bit longer than the usual video, because I want to take you guys every step of this build so you guys can build the same or better than my build. And okay then, not wasting any time, let's get build it. Okay, the expensive part in this build is only I bought the 1 horsepower motor, and the rest of the material is just the plywood that I can find on my workshop, and the rest is some part from my local scrapyard. Okay then, let's restart the build. The first is I'm using this 12mm plywood to make this impeller. This is going to be 35 diameter of this circle for the impeller. And after that, I make a center circle, 4-inch hole, suction hole, and I use 8 fins for this impeller. It's actually easy to make the 8 fin. You just divide 360 by 8, you will get 45 degree angle. So like so. And the next step, you're going to connect this 2 point with the line, like so. After that, just draw all the way. I'm going to determine the arc, the curve for my vins. This is how I find the curve for my vins. And this is when the arc meet for my pivot point to my compass, and now we have the curve for the 8 fins. Now I'm using this 50mm thick wood block for the fins. So before that, I'm going to determine how the length of these fins. So like so, that how I determine the length of the fins. After I draw the line like so, and the next I am going to find the center point between this line. Just draw a line again. Next step, I'm going to draw the curve on this wood block to make the fins. So before that, I just make the first stroke with my compass. For this first stroke with the pivot point, I can measure how thick and how many fins I'm going to make. And after that, I just cut it with my bandsaw. Yeah, as simple as that. This is the 8 fin. The next step, we're going to I sand it using my 2x72 belt grinder, but I think it's not so comfortable sanding with this, so I changed sanding with my drill press using my drum sander jig. You can check on this for this build. It's actually so simple. And the next step, I'm going to cut this impeller structure using my bandsaw with the circle jig. And the next step, I'm going to glue all these fins, these 8 fins, on that impeller structure with help of this stainless steel rod. This stainless steel rod is have a function of to line up the bottom circle and the top circle for this impeller structure by using this square. This method is give you the accurate alignment between the bottom structure and the top structure, believe me. After that, just clamp it together. You can see here, between the top and the bottom of this circle structure is lined up perfectly by just using this stainless steel rod and square. But this impeller need to be balanced because it's not balanced yet, like you can see there. I make marking and I will add some wood to make it balanced. After that, I just reinforce these fins using my pin nail. The next step, I'm going to build the enclosure, the housing for this impeller, and I will use this crossing line as my guide to determine the radius for this housing. First, I'm using is 2 centimeters, and the next is 4 centimeters, and after that just 6 centimeters and 8 centimeters, and get back to the first marking with the 2 centimeters. I'm marking this another 8 centimeters, so the total is 10. The next step, I'm going to connect that marking using my compass, like so. Okay, drawing the radius for this impeller housing is already done. You can see now. So the radius is from small to the large. And this is good for the static pressure and the airflow. So this is most used on this blower system. Okay, this is 8 vin impeller. So this 35 in diameter, so I make the same diameter, but the difference is the fins. This one I'm making 12 fins. So when you make the same diameter with a lot of fins, automatically you will shorter these fins. So why I make these two, because I want to compare the result of the static pressure between this 8 vin and this 12 vins, which one is have the better static pressure. Okay, then let's assembly this 12 vins, and we're going to test it. Okay, after assembly these 12 fins, and I will make a hole. This is the inlet hole or the suction hole. I'm using 4 inch or 100 millimeter in diameter for this suction hole. Okay, now I'm using this pulley wheel. This is actually pulley wheel. I use 1 horsepower motor. You can see here I have 1 horsepower with 2800 RPM. Okay, this pulley wheel is going to connect with this impeller, like so. So the next step, I will drill this with 5.1 millimeter drill bit, and after that just tap it with M6. I also make a hole in on the impeller, the same hole as the pulley wheel.
Okay, like you can see, already at this counterweight, so to make it balanced.
And now we're going to test for the power and the ampere with this impeller without housing. Like you can see, it draw a lot of ampere beyond this motor capacity, and that is not good. So I decide to reduce the diameter of this impeller by 2 centimeters. After that, I just check it again. Reducing the impeller diameter is also reducing the power and the ampere, but it's not enough. But I think if the housing is already attached and the installation for the dust collector is already been installed, I think it will reduce a lot of ampere and wattage also. I also add this additional ring for the suction hole.
Okay, already cutting all the material for the housing, and this is also this one. It's actually a few parts, so like this. Okay, then this is 12 millimeter, and this also 12 millimeter, and you will know this for, and this is 18 millimeter, and this circle is 18 millimeter. This is going to fit like so. Okay, and this one is also 18 millimeters, and this is going to fit inside like so. Okay, let's go assemble.
Okay, I add this double layer with the different size of this center circle is because this is going to be a quick release for the bracket and this impeller housing. So you will know in the end of this video why I make like so. Next step, I will make this center bracket. This is the circle, is I add also 2 layers with the different size of this circle. This is going to be the bracket that attached to the motor bracket. So this is going to be this housing bracket that can be quick released.
Okay guys, the glue up is already done, so you can see I have this glue together, and this one already glue up, and I add additional 4 bolt. This 4 bolt is going to be the locking mechanism, and I also add this dowel. This dowel is actually working like so. And I drill exactly at the center of this joint. So I add 4, 1, 2, and 3, 4. Actually, you can just add 2. Let's assembly this together, and we're going to make the cover for the outside diameter. Okay, I think already done assembly this housing for the impeller, and this I think is quite strong. This is HDPE. We also make this the locking mechanism. This is a 3 millimeter thick metal strip that I use. It's just like going to be like so. Okay, next step is we're going to try this for the first time, and before that, I'm going to attach this. This is the housing bracket, so like you already know, this is going to be like so, and this is going to be mounted on this motor bracket. So let's go then.
And this is the locking mechanism. Please check. If I tighten this locking mechanism, the housing is self-aligning with this bracket. You can see that. Okay, after it's done, we're going to check the power and the ampere. Okay, just slightly smaller than before, but it's still not enough. But the ampere is mostly the same with the motor capacity, that is 6.4. This is only 6.5. Now we're going to check the air velocity. Like you can see, it got 19 until 20 meter per second for the suction hole. And next we're going to measure for the outlet for this blower. I think around 25 air velocity for this outlet blower. Okay, I think I want to change this impeller, this 8-pin impeller with a 12-pin impeller. Let's see how the result. Okay, I think there is no difference between the 8-pin and the 12-pin for this impeller. The ampere is the same, the power is the same also. But check this out, it has bigger air velocity than the 8-pin. It's 27 on the suction hole and 27 on the outlet. It's far more different with the 8-pin.